What is up, amigos? Today we're talking about vortex generators on cars. We'll be going through what they are, how they work, and their effects on drag. And vortex generators are actually quite complicated. So let's talk about what they are to begin with. So let's say we're looking at a surface at the back of it, and so the flow is coming out of the page at us, and they often look like this. So vortex generators in general, they can take on a bunch of different shapes. In fact, pretty much anything can be a vortex generator. Even this pen, if you were to put it at a certain angle in the flow, this will create a vortex off there. But generally speaking, this is the most common shape. And as the flow hits the front of it and comes around it, it will start to create two vortices that will come downstream. And this is very important because we often use these vortices to manipulate the flow. So in what situations would we do this? So let's say we're looking from the side now and we have this vortex generator and we have vortices coming off it and one on the other side. So what it does is with the boundary layer that forms over this, and if you don't know what boundary layers in aerodynamics are, check out this video here. And when the boundary layer comes over this surface and the vortex generator here, these vortices, they start mixing in faster moving flow from either the top part of the boundary layer or even the free stream flow into the lower part of the boundary layer. The reason why this is important is because if you start to have a curved surface, often flows will detach. And this is because they simply do not have enough energy to stay attached over the surface. So by having this vortex generator here, mixing in this high momentum fluid, which is generally the technical term for saying what it does, this fast moving fluid into this boundary layer region, it keeps the flow attached and it can go over the surface longer. So what that does is, because we have an attached flow, the wake is smaller and then the drag drops. So that's the general effect on the drag, but that doesn't necessarily mean that vortex generators are good all the time. In fact, there are some situations where vortex generators are actually bad. So these vortex generators to begin with, let's say we have a surface and we have a vortex generator here. Well, the flow is coming here and it's hitting it and then it makes these vortices. These vortices are actually wakes when you think about it. They're just a very specialized type of wake. And we use this type of wake to manipulate the flow to our benefit, which is to keep these flows attached. And we often find them, we don't really find them very much on road cars because often they aren't that great looking, etc. But often if we were to use them, we'd put them on the back just where the roof meets the back window, because this region is often where the flow will detach. So putting them there will keep the flow attached. But you can put them on any curved surface or any surface really where the flow does separate. This will then create this exchange of momentum from the higher fast moving flow to the slow moving flow. But if we don't have that and the flow isn't really going to be separating, then all this is just an additional wake which results in the pressure drag increasing. So there's a delicate balance between making the pressure drag drop because we are keeping the flow attached and increasing the pressure drag just because we're introducing this wake here. Also, because we have fast moving flow near the surface here, the friction drag regardless will increase, and also because the flow is now attached, the friction drag will also increase as well. So this is a delicate balancing act between dropping the pressure drag enough and not increasing the friction drag as much as we can possibly do. So overall, what kind of benefits do we see from these vortex generators? Well, depending on where you put them on the car, they can result in a huge amount of increase in lift or reduction in drag. Generally speaking, they are used on road cars, like the cars that you buy from the shop just to drive around yourself. They're usually used for drag reduction purposes. And generally speaking, we see about a 10% reduction in the overall drag, which is a really amazing result. That's like 25 counts, which is the equivalent of like completely covering up your rims of your car, or even more drastically changing the diffuser, etc. So they do have very big effects on the drag, which are very beneficial, but depending on the situation. And also, it also depends on the speed. So if you're driving around very slowly and the flow is detaching, you put these vortex generators on the back of the roof near the window, there's no guarantee that these vortex generators will help the boundary layer stay attached that much longer, because you're not really traveling that fast. So first of all, there's not very fast moving flow here to mix in, but also these vortices aren't as strong either. And in terms of the height of these vortex generators, because they're protruding out so far, as I mentioned, they create quite a big wake. So this has led to something called microvortex generators, which is if you have a surface and you have the boundary layer over here, they only pop up about one third of the height of the boundary layer. Whereas historically, vortex generators went into the entire boundary layer and went to the free stream region. These microvortex generators come with the additional drop in the drag, but they don't get this penalty in the pressure drag nearly as much. So that's a caveat to vortex generators. So that is vortex generators in a nutshell. If you like this video, make sure to like it. If you want to see more like this, click the subscribe button. And if you want to learn more about this kind of thing, check out a course by JKF, which we have in the link in the description. And I'll see you next video. Peace out, amigos.